Hi and welcome to my fifth video in the series about cell membranes, and today we're going to be looking at answering exam questions. So the questions we're going to be looking at today are from the EdExcel qualification for AS Biology, and this is taken from the Unit 1 paper. And so the question that states, the diagram below represents the structure of a cell surface membrane. And part A, explain why the phospholipid molecules form a bilayer. So the question is asking why the phospholipid molecules form a bilayer. So looking at the diagram, you've got a number of different things labelled here. You've got intrinsic proteins, you have glycoproteins or glycocalyx, and you also have cholesterol molecules. But the bit it's actually interested in is the phospholipid molecules. So the phospholipids are made of two parts. They have a head part and a tail part. And so the first mark for this question will be the fact that the fatty acids, or the tails, are hydrophobic, which means they don't like water. So the fact that they are hydrophobic means they'll orientate themselves away from the water, or the polar environment in this case. So obviously if the tails are hydrophobic and they move away from water, the heads are hydrophilic, and therefore that's another mark. From there you can basically say that they interact, or the orientate themselves towards the water or the polar environment, so saying where they are, where they position themselves. And therefore, if you reference the fact that the cytoplasm, the tissue fluid, and that they're found in is a polar environment, or the fact that there is a large amount of water there present, you therefore get the fifth mark. And this question's worth three marks, so it's any three from those that are available. The next part of the question goes on to ask a section about beetroot and about the permeability of beetroot in the presence of alcohol. And essentially what the experiment is about is they put pieces of beetroot in with different concentrations of ethanol in this case, and they see the intensity of the red coloration of the liquid that's produced. And the question states, suggest two variables other than those stated above which could be kept constant during the experiment. So if you actually look at the text first, and we see some of the things that they've actually kept constant, some of the things like one piece of beetroot was placed into a tube containing 15 centimetres cubed of water and left for 15 minutes, so those were all controlled. The procedure was repeated 7 times, so doing repeats. Each piece of beetroot was removed from the tubes and a sample of fluid removed and placed in the calorimeter, essentially a piece of equipment to determine the intensity of the red coloration. And so suggest two of the variables other than those stated above which could be kept constant during this experiment. There are a number of things that haven't been mentioned in the method, so anything from the temperature of the ethanol, the surface area or the volume of the beetroot, the part of the beetroot that was used, potentially the age, the variety, how it was stored, and the source where you got it from, the volume of ethanol, although the concentration is the variable that you alter. The volume of ethanol in each case must be the same, and they must be measuring the same wavelength of light in the calorimeter also, so any two of those are valid. So part two for this question states there was some red coloration in the tube containing only water, suggest an explanation for this. What this is saying is if we believe that it's the ethanol causing the breakdown of the cell membrane and causing the leaching of the pigment that gives beetroot its red color, then how come we got some red coloration from only water? And clearly when the beetroot was cut, some damage may have been done to the cells, and so therefore the cell membranes could have been damaged, and hence some of the pigment could have leaked out of the cells. So saying first of all that damage was caused when the physically when the beetroot was cut, and therefore causing the leakage of some of the pigment, gets you the second mark. So part three, describe what the student could have done to reduce the red coloration in the tube containing only the water. And so two possibilities here. One is rinse it off with water before you start, or two, potentially dab it and to remove any of the excess pigment on the outside. Part C, the graph shows on page 10 that the ethanol has had the effect of the permeability on the beetroot. State the effect that the ethanol concentration has on the intensity of the red coloration. So if we go back to the graph, you can see here, generally speaking, that as the concentration of ethanol increases, the intensity of red coloration also increases. You can tell it's a reasonably simple answer because there's only one mark available. If there was more marks available, you may be expected to quote numbers from the graph. And to suggest an explanation for this is part two, and this is worth 2 marks. And you can get it for any of the following. So, reference to the disruption of the membrane. So, saying that the ethanol has some effect on the membrane is a single mark. From there, you can say that ethanol is a solvent, which means it, something can dissolve into it, a bit like how water can dissolve sugar. Water, in this case, is a solvent, and the ethanol is a solvent in this case. And the idea that some of the lipids can dissolve within the ethanol, hence it's a solvent. You can also get marks here for saying the following, so that the idea that the increase in the ethanol causes the solution to be less polar. Essentially, the parts on the outside of the beetroot cells have less water in them, and so they become less polar. And that therefore changes the orientation of the phospholipids. Now, if you remember back, looking at the diagram, you can see that you've got the phospholipids that have the tails on the inside and the heads on the outer. Now, that's only dependent on the fact that the heads are hydrophilic and the tails are hydrophobic. So if there's less water available surrounding the membrane, then you can expect the phospholipids not to be in a bilayer.